I'm going to address some misinformation that is being spread among the public regarding avoiding getting infected or regarding treating the coronavirus. Some of it is really superstition and complete nonsense, so it really shouldn't even need to be argued. But I'm just running through it quickly. Cow urine, homeopathy, cow dung, standing in sunlight, chanting, whatever, none of it is going to help. The virus doesn't care. The virus doesn't care that you're drinking cow urine or taking homeopathic medicines. I don't actually know what can be reliably, provably cured by homeopathic medicines, but viruses are definitely not at it. This kind of misinformation is very problematic because the government has also engaged in providing it to people. Please do not do that. Vibrations of chants of anything, vibrations of shank, none of it does anything to the virus. But there is also more serious wrong information. Some of it is not necessarily misinformation, but information we earlier believed to be true, which later got proved incorrect. I'm just running through some of that. For example, the virus can live only for 3 hours on some external surface without exiting, without infecting a host. So there is a belief that the virus cannot live on surfaces for a very long time, and if you leave a surface alone for about 3 hours, it should be safe to touch again. This is not true. Scientists in various experiments have shown that the virus can live on surfaces easily for up to 3 hours. The surfaces include metal, plastic, cloth, paper. Another piece of information shows that the virus under some conditions can live on a surface for up to 25 days. So clearly the 3 hour thing is the surface is not going to be safe. You have to disinfect it for it to be safe. There are people who believe that the virus cannot reinfect people who are already infected. So if people are infected and they get better or they don't fall ill, they have immunity now. And there is also a group of people who believes that we just let people get infected so that we have herd immunity and we don't fall ill. This is problematic because 80% of the people getting infected may not have symptoms serious enough to take them to hospital or cause serious damage to them. But 20% of the people will end up on ventilators and really in hospital and at threat of death. So deliberately infecting people or deliberately courting infection or seeing it as a strategy for prevention is not going to work. Even more importantly, the problem with this is that the idea that once someone is infected, they are immune is not necessarily true. The virus has 2 strains at least, and there may be more because it mutates. And there have already been reported instances of people who were discovered to be, who were cured to again have succumbed to the virus. So obviously the immunity thing is not working as reliably as people would want to believe. Maintaining 3 to 6 feet distance may keep you safe. It's not necessarily true. Chinese researchers tracing the spread of infection and studying surveillance video discovered that one person was able to infect 2 other people who were 15 feet away from him in a bus. They speculate that the draft of air from the air conditioner helped the virus travel further in the bus. But here's the thing, there are breezes, there's fans, there's air conditioning everywhere. Even standing outside, there can be an ambient breeze, so you can't really guarantee that 3 to 6 feet will keep you safe. Also, 3 to 6 feet is not really proven in any sense, it's just assumed. So obviously, the more distance you are able to keep, the better. If you are actually actively able to put a barrier like a mask or glasses between you and potential infection, that's still better. Take measures to disinfect. Don't just assume on passive distance protecting you adequately. It's better and best stay at home. Only nose and mouth are at risk of being infected. This is actually not true also. While nose and covering your nose and mouth is more important because you're inhaling and exhaling, and when you cough and sneeze, you can propel particles of the virus out. It's not only the nose and mouth that can be infected. For example, the cells in your eyes can also be infected by the virus. The virus can enter your body like this as well. But because of the tears in our eyes and constant blinking and not much movement of air in that sense, unlike breathing. So the chances of infecting are less than they would be by, say, simply inhaling the virus in, or your hands touching your face or your lips with the virus particles on them. Covering your nose and mouth is more important, but it's not true that only the nose and mouth can be infected. Only old people get infected. This is not true. There have been cases of people as young as 4 years old being infected. There have been reports of people who are very young and very fit being infected. But yes, it is true that there's a larger number of old people among those who are infected. So it's important to protect the old people, but do not be complacent. Medicines. WhatsApp is full of people claiming various cures for the coronavirus. As of now, there is no proven cure. Doctors are obviously desperate to treat this thing. They are trying various things to various degrees of effect. But right now, there is no confirmed cure for the coronavirus, or we would not have increasing cases. We'd be curing them. Okay? So please do not believe those forwards, and even more importantly, do not buy and self-medicate. There have been cases where people got the name of a medicine from WhatsApp, they went ahead and purchased and took it, and they landed up in hospital because of the medicine. One person has died. So this is without getting infected. They took the medicine to prevent an infection and the medicine killed him. So please do not do this. This is serious stuff. If you get a cold, you stick to your regular cold, flu medication.